Hello folks, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Now in today's video, I'm going to be diving into an application called Columns, which is now out of beta. Now I first saw this application on Product Hunt back in December roughly, and they've now released the official version of it. It is like a Columns checklist application with a little bit of a twist, because you can create these columns or checklists using different sort of, I guess like sort of micro statuses, from checklists to dots to bullet points. I will guide you through this application over on the laptop. So I'm going to give you my first impressions, details about the application, and also recommendations on who this is most suitable for. So let's jump over to the laptop and dive into Columns. Okay folks, so here we are with Columns, and you can find it at columns.me. Now the sort of premise of this application is checklists arranged in columns. Now they say here that it's used for keeping thoughts, notes, tasks, project and watch lists. And what great is it works with teams and individuals. So as you can imagine, it's becoming quite popular. It was in beta back in December. So I'm actually going to go and build some boards whilst I'm talking to you here. So as you can see, the design on the left-hand panel, you get an account, you get today, which is pre-built for you with to-do, watch list, later, and archive. So very simple sort of columns to get you started. They also have this My Project area, which is really simply laid out like sort of a Kanban. You can move cards between these. You can even move cards between boards, and that's really essentially to get you started. You've also got trash as well for any deleted cards, and down in the bottom right hand corner you can actually empty the trash there. Now in the bottom left hand corner you can add a new workspace, so if you wanted to create one for your team, and there is also preferences here. You can hide the sidebar, you can also change the language and follow them on Twitter, but currently there is no pricing confirmed. So let's go ahead and show you around the application by adding a few tasks. So let's say I wanted to add a very simple task of shop. Now, what you can do is naturally add some notes below. You can also add a file. You can simply drag it on there if you wanted to. And you can set a date. I really like the dropout menu, and they do have natural language input apparently. So if I selected today, as you can see, that picks out for today. So I could go below and add a few items. Okay, so as you can see, the shop is created here. And if you open these up, you can see that you can tick the item off. You can set another date if you want to. And that works with, for example, next week it will come up. And you can even set a color for them as well. So if you wanted to highlight this one in blue, you can also add attachments from here and move it in different statuses. So for example, if it showed I was doing the task, it's sort of like half done, and mark is done would be checking it off completely. But in this case, I'm just gonna mark it as a to-do. Now I can copy the link, and if I was working in a team, I could send that to other people, and I can switch notifications off for this if any updates come from team members as well. So over here, you can also start adding notes or comments below here. And it also works with Markdown, so you can add any Markdown text below, which might be helpful. Something you can do is if you go to My Profile, you can actually upload a photo here too. So I have shop in there, so tomorrow I actually need to edit a video. So I'm also going to put that as tomorrow in my area and press enter on it. So as you can see, the task appears just below. So next week I need to call charity shop. I'm going to put here next week. So as you can see, tasks begin appearing pretty neatly over here, and it becomes very linear. So what you can go do is press the settings or options and go to add heading. So for example, if I wanted to create a next week heading, so I can sort of see the task for next week, I can begin dragging items below And as you can see, that looks a little bit neater. Now in any of the headings, if I wanted to add a description, I can do that here. So if I wanted to change the title of this column specifically, I can go and do that. So there you go, I've updated the title and the description. Now any of these columns, I can actually go ahead and delete. It will give me a little bit of a confirmation, but I can actually go and clear all of this out. So I can also go ahead and add a new column at any given time. And as you can imagine, I can add whatever I want to below. In this case, I'm going to keep this one pretty clear for now. So what's really cool is below today, I can actually change the color of this one. So the pin actually comes up on the left-hand side with another color. I can change it to whatever I like. I can also go ahead and edit the board as well. So I can give it some notes on what the board is about. I can change the title. I can delete the board as well, which is incredibly helpful. And I can change it from checkboxes to arrows, apparently. So you can see the arrows appear there. So that's just a slight preference change. You can even change it to dots if you wanted to, which might be more suitable for those who like outline applications, and dashes as well. Now you can even have nothing if you didn't want anything at all. In this case, I'm actually just going to keep it as dots. So the other thing you can do is add boards below. So if I wanted to, for example, change this shopping list into something a little bit stronger, say I wanted it in dots and I wanted to create an ongoing shopping list, this could be helpful. I can move this around however I like and it acts as a project. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to actually create an inventory so I can start tallying all the stuff I already have. So as you can see, I have three separate columns for that. And what I can do is actually go down here and create different sections. For example, I could say groceries. And as you can see, it's very simple to start adding that. And what I can do is, for example, if I know that I'm going to be planning and using this on the mobile application, they do have a mobile web version. They don't have a mobile app, just to be clear. So I can steal and utilize the heading, and I can actually remove some of these, for example. So as you can see, what I could do is, for example, as soon as I'm out of items in the inventory, I could just move them over to the relevant section. So in this case, it would go underneath the groceries. So this can be a handy way to plan in a sort of style Kanban experience. Now, if you and your team were, say, planning a roadmap of releases, I could, for example, use this for a content calendar. Let's see how that would look like. So for example, I'm going to go with dashes for this one. So for example, here I've given some, say, weeks that I want to release these on. And let's say I wanted to break these up in terms of headings as well. So as you can see, I've sort of created a template to some extent, very simply by creating these headers and also this title here. So what I might want to do is go up to here and press duplicate. So as you can see, I duplicated this here. Now what I could do is actually drag this one to the end. And what I could do is press edit column and take out the main number at the top. And what I could do is simply minimize this. So in order to minimize it, all I have to do is press on the center. And as you can see, it disappears. So that could be a good way to create a very subtle template inside of checklists and quite a neat way to do it in that. Below here, I could add all of the cards and details, etc. And for example, if I wanted to add some details about this one I'm filming, so I'm going to set this one to today. Now, the thing that I noticed is you can't, for example, when you set that as today, for it to appear in this today section. So that's one of the things that I think they probably could add. For example, being able to actually set a link to, an inbox or a today area, which may help you to correlate all of the things that need doing for a specific day. So for example, if I went ahead and completed that week, I could minimize it like that and focus on the weeks ahead only. So that's quite a neat way in being able to plan a roadmap or content without necessarily building a timeline view. So for example, another thing you can do is drag files into the area. So as you can see there, the image comes up as a preview. So that's something that you can do. You can also tap the image to go into it. And also hide the image as well if you don't want it appearing up. But that's specifically helpful. They had some a few Pokemon demonstration of this, but that could be a good way to visually see. Okay, folks, so this was a very basic demonstration of the application. But if I'm honest, I was actually pretty impressed at the way this application works. It's not too cluttered. It allows you to focus on what matters. And what's cool is on this side, they're not restricting you to following a process. So checklist lovers will fall in love with this application instantly. Now, who I most recommend this for? I really recommend this for those who are looking for a simple checklist application that builds some checklists in a very visual fashion without being too overwhelming in Kanban. It is perfect for those who are building very simple lists. You want to be able to keep a tally of the things you need to watch, the places you want to go, and all of that sort of stuff. Then this is a perfect application for you. It's super lightweight and works very well, and even has some, I guess, advanced customizations that I think a lot of people would appreciate. Now, if you're a team, you can actually open up a new workspace. So for example, in this case, let's create one for Keep Productive. So as you can see, when you've got a new Keep Productive area, that appears on this left-hand side, getting you started and separating the information. There's some capabilities for teams and also solo users as well. Now, I'm incredibly impressed by this application. I really like the way that it blends a task manager and sort of outline a concept together in one application. Now, in my opinion, they could do a few things with the task relationships, but I'm very impressed. This application's free at the moment, so we don't know the pricing. We don't have a mobile application at the moment. And if I'm honest, I did notice some slight delay in duplicating experiences, but again, it's very early days for this application. It's bound to have a few bugs and issues when you're getting started. So folks, thank you so much, and I will talk to you all very soon. Please do subscribe if you're brand new, and I look forward to keeping an eye on this application, actually. Anyway, folks, cheerio.